Okay, I'm ready. All right, we're going to be doing a simulation today on a woman that has just delivered by cesarean section for failure to progress. Her name is Beverly Johannes. Her date of birth is 5/12/85. She has a recent history of pregnancy-induced hypertension. She was treated during labor and also postpartum with max sulfate for the pregnancy-induced hypertension and Pitocin to induce labor. Mom also is positive for group B strep, and she is also Rh negative. Her estimated blood loss during surgery was 1,500 milliliters. She delivered a baby boy this morning at 8:05. The baby is in NICU due to hypothermia and respiratory distress. The child weighed 3,420 grams, and Apgar scores were 6 and 8. Mom remains in labor and delivery recovery room due to the continuation of the magnesium sulfate and her elevated blood pressure. Her last two sets of vital signs at 11 o'clock were 170 over 100, pulse 102, respirations 20, and temperature 98.2. At 1 o'clock, or 1300, it was 166 over 99, pulse 95, respirations 18, and temperature 99. You have orders that you will need to review, medications, IV fluids, and also general care, and that will be that you will be responsible for. Okay. Are you feeling, or how are you feeling? What's bothering you?
I just feel blah. I just want to go back to sleep. I really don't feel good right now.
Okay. Well, you had a pretty tough labor and delivery, and you're on some medications that can sometimes make you feel that way. Okay? So let me, first thing, before we go any further, can you give me your name and your date of birth?
Beverly Johannes, and my birthday is May 12, 1985.
Okay. Do you know if you have any allergies or not?
Not that I know of.
Okay. All right. Well, let me check you over and see how you're doing today, and then we'll look at the doctor's orders and see if there's anything we can do to help you feel better, okay? So the first thing I'm going to start with, Ms. Johannes, is to look in your eyes, okay? I want to see how constrictive your eye your pupils are, okay? I'm just going to shine a little light. Okay, all right. Are you experiencing any kind of headache?
Little.
I feel tired. You feel tired. What about blurred vision?
No, I can see okay.
You can see okay? Okay. Any spots or anything?
No.
Okay. Well, good. So I want you to take a deep breath for me, a couple of in and out. Good. Begin. sit you up, and I'm going to listen to your back, okay? There you go. I know you are. I know. Take a deep breath for me. Radial pulses. Make sure they're equal and bilateral. Tap refill. Alright, can you squeeze my fingers? A little weak, huh? Are you just that sleepy this morning? Ms. Johannes, are you planning on breastfeeding or bottle feeding?
I want to breastfeed. I don't like the idea of
being able to do it. Okay, well, that's good. Are you wearing a bra? Do you know? Did they put a bra on you?
I'm wearing a bra.
Okay, good. That's very important that you wear that, whether you're breastfeeding or bottle feeding, because it helps support the breast. And help them not feel so heavy as that milk is starting to come in, okay? Later on, when you feel better, we will get the lactation consultant in the room to talk with you and visit with you about breastfeeding and answer any questions that you may have, okay? Have you noticed any redness or soreness to your breast?
They're really swollen and tender.
Okay. You know, remember those first few days, that colostrum is starting to, is that precursor to the breast milk, and it's coming in and it's going to, it could make you feel a little engorged, and so that's not unusual. Any leakage from your breast that you've noticed?
Just a little bit. Is that normal?
It is very normal, okay? And as soon as we can get you with your baby, we'll see about getting him to the breast, and cause that colostrum has a lot of great antibodies that help that baby, his immune system, and it also has great calories to help keep them growing and keep them hydrated.
Hmm?
What's that? Say that again?
Where is my baby?
Oh, your baby had to go to the neonatal ICU. He's okay. He was a little cold. And when they're cold like that and they can't warm up right after birth, then they sometimes have some trouble breathing. But he is breathing on his own. He does have some oxygen going, okay? And as soon as we can get you feeling better, we're going to take you down to NICU to see him. Or if he starts getting better, we'll bring him to see you, okay?
Okay.
Okay. All right. All right. So the next thing I'll...
I feel so tired.
I know.
Are we almost done?
Almost. Almost. I'm going to get through this, okay? All right. I'm going to check your abdomen. Okay? All right. I'm going to listen to bowel sounds. Movement was?
My husband said I pooped the day that I gave birth, but I don't really remember. I think
Okay. Now, I do need to just kind of check your tummy a little bit. I'll be as gentle as I can. Make sure you're not too distended. I know. I hear you. So you have a catheter. Let me check that. A catheter is draining the urine from your bladder.
I see a lot.
Not a whole lot. We'd like to see a little bit more, okay? Now you have a dressing here. It does have a little bit of bloody drainage on it. Nothing serious, but I am going to call the doctor and let them know, okay, about this.
What, normal after surgery?
It is somewhat, okay, but we just don't want too much, okay? So we're going to check that out. Okay, I want to check your size.
I feel really wet down there. Did I go to the bathroom by myself?
Let me check here. Hold on. Okay. No, you did not wet on yourself, but you did. You are having some vaginal bleeding. I'm checking the normal vaginal bleeding that women have after having a baby. Okay. Quite a bit. One thing I'm going to need to do is to massage your fundus, okay?
What?
The top, your uterus, okay? The fundus is the top of the uterus, and make sure it's nice and firm, okay? And I know this is not going to be comfortable since you had a C-section. I'm going to place my hand right across where your incision is, okay? I'm going to be as gentle as I can. You're going to feel my fingers around your belly button, okay? And I'm just going to be massaging, okay, and pressing, and watching for any more bleeding, okay? Okay, all right. Let's get you cleaned up a little bit, okay? Never want to leave your patient like this, okay? This is alarming, and we do want to identify and note it, but we do not want to leave our patient with this bloody pad, okay? Okay, thank you. I'm going to get some help in here to help me, okay? So we can get you turned over. Come in.
I was told you needed help.
Yes, thank you.
My gloves on. Hello, Michelle Hansen. I'm Dawn. I'm just going to give a hand, okay? What I'm going to have you do is reach across to me. We're going to get you turned over, all right?
Yes, there is. That's not unusual. One of the medications that you're on can cause some bleeding, but I am going to talk with your physician and let them know what's happening, okay? And let them know, see if they have any other orders, okay?
We're going to have you go back.
Right. Here we go. There you go.
All right, Mr. Hansen. We're going to have you reach across to the other side now.
There you go.
All right. There you go.
Thank you, Dawn.
You're welcome. I'll go put this in a red bag.
Okay.
I'll bring the red bag back in.
Thank you. Okay.
we're going to do is I'm just going to check your lower extremity. Any pain in your calf?
No, not really.
Okay. Can you push down on my hand? Good job. Can you pull back? Good job. One thing I want to check, one of the medications you are on can kind of suppress your reflexes. So I'm going to check your reflexes in your lower extremity. Okay? Just relax your leg. Other one. Good. Good pulses, good circulation in your lower extremity. That's great. Are you in any pain right now? Sore and tired. Okay, let me. Alright. Okay, ringers with 20th Pitocin at 50 mils per hour. And your other medication that you're getting in your IV is magnesium sulfate. Let me review the doctor's orders and see if there's anything else we need to do. So you're saying you're just sore. On a scale of 0 to 10, can you rate that pain for me?
About a
6
or a
7, I think. Okay, a 6 or a 7. Any nausea? Any vomiting?
No, I just, my stomach really hurts.
Okay.
I don't know if it's just sore or if I'm hungry.
Okay. Well, I'm going to check to see when the last time you got something for pain, and hopefully we can get you something to help you feel better. The one thing I am a little concerned about is your blood pressure. It's 178 over 97, and that's from that, you know, the pregnancy-induced hypertension that you've had that we've been treating you for. And so I'm going to, your doctor has ordered a medication called a Presalene. And we're going to go get that and give that to you since your blood pressure is a little high. Okay? If we can get your blood pressure down a little bit lower, then yes, I think, you know, we'll talk to the physician and about getting you over to the neonatal ICU to see your little boy. How about that? Okay? You're welcome. For right now, I just want you to rest, and I'll be back in a few moments with the pain medication and your blood pressure medication.